I don't know. There's just so much that goes into this game. It's an honor to be here, isn't it?
It is an honor, and I can't wait to share this game with you. This is going to be a whole lot of fun. You're my partner, my best friend. I can't imagine being anywhere else but right here with you. And just think about it this way. You mentioned the magnitude. This is no walk. For America, or even North America. This is worldwide. People watching from just about every country in the world. This is impressive.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and just about ready to roll. Here on first down, and his throw's going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. First time with Devontae Freeman. And some room to maneuver. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
I can say this from experience, especially from a defensive back's perspective. There's not many things more terrifying than a toss sweep or a pitch play and all that beef out in front of the runner.
Yeah, I had an old coach say three words on those plays, toss or pitch. Set the edge. Heard them over and over.
A lot of times they roll.
Down carry, and he'll be taken down at the 34. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Now Ryan on second down. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he's brought down after a good game. And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. On second down, here's Ryan. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. He needed 3, he got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard. Looks like the defense in press coverage here, and they're going to go soft on the corners. Here's Ryan. It's caught, Jones. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Julio Jones, 26 yards. And the Falcons take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. That time... A six-play drive, and the Falcons score to cap it off. Now after the touchdown, it's Boshier to kick it away. Take it in the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee, and that's at the 25. Play action here on first down. And his first pass is incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Michael Floyd. And now it's second down. And on this offense, a guy that kind of came in under the radar, Lewis.
Hard to believe that Deion Lewis was that far under the radar. There is something to precedent from schools. Played at Pitt, and they do know how to churn out running backs.
10 yards still left on second down. First first carry for LeGarrette Blount. They find some open field here. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And Charles, a note on Blount, his best year statistically this season in his eight-year career. First time topping 1,000 yards since he was a rookie.
Yeah, he went over 1,100, 18 touchdowns on the ground. What a phenomenal season. If I'm not mistaken, he had never had more than 7 rushing touchdowns in a year before.
Correct.
Wow, what a big-time year for him. And all that does is open things up for Tom Brady in the passing game.
Give him 22 on that one. And it gives the Pats a first down.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah.
Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
7 yards on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Play clock all the way to 0. Didn't get the snap off. 5-yard penalty.
And you see the head coach writing that note on his play sheet right now. He's going to be addressing that with his staff. A sense of urgency. Get to the line of scrimmage. Snap the ball.
Shift together here from the D-line. On play action, now Brady looking deep downfield. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Collins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always at the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Now Ryan down around the goal line. He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toy Lolo. It'll be a 3-yard gain. And just like that, it's third down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
So here we go, a third down. From the gun on third down, Ryan. He finds Coleman, and he gets this one all the way up to the 40. A big play that time on the catch and run, 33 yards.
After that nice game there, for the rest of the game, the defense is going to have to respect the running backs as passing threats as well, not just play them strictly to run the football. They may be able to get downfield and catch it too.
First and 10, it's Ryan. Connects with Sanu right side. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Second down now after the pass completion. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On second down, Freeman. stays on his feet. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. They got two of the three they needed there. It leaves them with third and just a yard.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up the play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
On third and short, the fullback DeMarco. And he will have the first down as he gets this to the 47.
Third and one, who are you going to call? Not the scat back. You go with the big man. Hand him the ball and let him get upfield and pick up a first down.
And here comes play number six on this drive. This is Freeman on first and 10. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Now they'll throw it with Ryan. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he'll lose yardage here back at the 41. It'll be a loss of a yard. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. And the wideout in motion. Intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're going to go for it on fourth down here. Fourth down, here's Ryan. And this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Patriots defense is going to take over on down. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you and I both been to practices where we've seen, hey, third down situation, big third down alert, lock in here, fourth down play, make sure you focus just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
On second down, here's Brady. He's got time. He's going to wind up and air it out. And this is caught inside the 5. A big play there for New England. 57 yards. The last drive, he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know, there's a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw 5 and still find a way to win the game in the end.
They'll go to Blunt, try and pound it in. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. LeGarrette Blount taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. The New England defense gearing up to take the field, and an important stop in a tight game their last time.
Always important to stop them, we know that. But as you noted, in a tight game, so much more critical to get it done, and that's exactly what they did.
And they'll be trying to do that once more here. We'll see who wins the battle. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. Third and long. It's Ryan. Hard throw, incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And fourth down coming up.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Taking on the midfield logo. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And the Patriots will have great starting position as they take over first and 10. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Now Brady trying to hit the tight end Bennett, but it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
Now a play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And on second and 10 now. Second and 10, it's Ryan again. And this is incomplete. Trying to get that in the hands of Devontae Freeman that time. And it'll bring up third down.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
On third down, Ryan trying to lay one up deep. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Pulled in at the 24. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Patriots take over. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something is funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Now Brady throwing on second down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. Give him 2 yards on that play, and they're going to have a third down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He was a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. On the toss, this is Blunt. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. Again, here's Blunt. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 11 yards on the pickup, and it'll give the Patriots a first down. From midfield, here's Brady. And right side caught Hogan. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
Well, 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Brady now on first down. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. Are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. A good pickup there, a 22.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run. Not two tight ends on the field, both of them with the ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
Brady now to throw. Pass incomplete. He was looking to find some space for Deion Lewis there. That'll bring up second down. Second down following the incompletion. They come out 5 wide. 3 of them to the right side. On second down, here's Brady. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on, because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
Brady now on third and goal. And Brady going to be enters down the numbers. There he goes. Picked off by Jalen Collins. 30, 20, 10, 5. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. Well, we know this defense has athleticism. Spots like that prove us right.
I love the way that you spotlighted the athleticism, because you and I both know the best athletes on the field, they play on defense.
I don't know. I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on. Come on.
Fine. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Patriot offense set to take over again. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right? Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much, right?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have a good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Brady to throw on second down. Going for the deep ball. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. And let's shift now to talking about the Patriots' defense. Their stay on the field last time was short-lived with a three and out. See if they can get some more of that.
And ordinarily, you want to be on the field playing, right? But three and out, that's almost gold to a defense. Get to the bench, get some rest, turn the ball over to your offense.
We'll see what they can do here, see if they can force another three and out. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he'll take this for about four up to the 46-yard line. Two Patriots there to bring him down. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. He's got time in the pocket. And he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the five. Quick strike ability.
Basketball. Guys boxing other guys off to go out and get a rebound.
And he got the rebound right there. But the defense was really placed well.
Yeah, they were right there. I mean, that's where it's really tough for a defender. When you're in the right spot, you're draped on the guy catching the ball, yet he still comes down with it.
Here's Bryant for the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays. The long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. Gets fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Throwing on first down is Brady. To the right side, and he's got Edelman. So one quarter down here at Super Bowl 51. Plenty of scoring here already. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Brady gives now to Blunt. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll get 3-yard line. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. And the hard count got the defense there. Encroachment and a 5-yard penalty.
Encroachment defense. Still first down.
So 5 yards remain now. Still first down. Shotgun now for Brady. And his throw here is incomplete. The wideout, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver.
Well, partners, that pass ball is incomplete. How about a few guys who will probably look at this season as being incomplete for them? And I'll start with Carlos Hyde, the nice runner for the San Francisco 49ers. 12 yards shy of 1,000.
In the backfield, Melvin Gordon, 3 yards shy of 1,000. And Devontae Adams on the receiving end, he finished with 997 as well. And how about Matt Ryan throwing the ball? 56 shy of 5,000. Now he'll be in the playoffs, but won't get the 5,000 for the regular season.
Yeah, and 5,000 yards throwing the ball for a quarterback nowadays, that's a heck of a benchmark. But what a season for Matty Ice. When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, and all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
On first and 10, here's Brady. And it's incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Second down now after the incompletion. Blunt, the lone running back. Brady again here on second and 10. This will be caught inside the 10. And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now Blunt. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now Brady throwing on second down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line.
So they were stopped trying to run the ball on first down. Now they take a sack on second down. The offensive coordinator's got to find a way to flip the script on the defensive coordinator because right now the defense has the advantage.
From the gun on third down, Brady. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Chris Hogan from 4 yards out. And the Patriots are back within a score. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown.
In their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower. Bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive. It got his man complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line.
Now, that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
So the offense has it first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And down inside the 35, he goes to the 32-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. Shipped together here from the D-line. On second down, Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
I still remember the first time I saw Julio Jones play in college. And then I got it confirmed at the NFL Combine. He is like an unbelievable thoroughbred coming out of the gates. I mean, his ability to accelerate and take in the distance and play with such physicality downfield. One of the best receivers in the league. Second in yardage this year despite missing 2 games with a toe injury.
That's right. Second to T.Y. Hilton. Finished with 1,409 did Julio Jones. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Give him 3 on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's third down. On third down, Ryan. Finding Gabriel complete. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Taylor Gabriel, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
Fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
They'll run again with Blum. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down? Brady going to try and throw on third down. Backing up. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. Now a carry for Blum. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 1 yard there, and now second down. Brady to throw on second down. Surveying the field. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Offense needs 11. Have to think pass here on third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. Going up top. And that's caught inside the 30. Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They'll run it here with Blunt. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Vic Beasley able to make the tackle. Now Brady. And now here is another. interception. Picked off by Jalen Collins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And that gives him now 3 interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get 3 in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
right. Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
All right, let's go tangential for a second. Give the viewers a behind-the-scenes look at our pregame meal with our production crew. Two of our cameramen, Jared and Deuce, one a Dolphins fan, one a Steelers fan. They're going head-to-head because those two teams will meet in the playoffs. It was interesting to hear them debate, wasn't it?
It. Think about how these two teams met in the regular season. Miami, 1-4 at the time. They beat Pittsburgh in a big-time upset. That kick-started their season. Miami won 9 of their next 10 games. In Pittsburgh, they lost their next 4, counting that game. So they went to a tailspin before finishing it strong with 7 straight wins. I think Big Ben, though, back in the lineup. Pittsburgh at home. I like the Steelers in this matchup.
Now Ryan on first down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. From the gun on third down, Ryan. And he's gets it in. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. On first down, Ryan. Sanu with a grab over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back to the running game. It's Freeman. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42. The defensive tackle, Alan Branch, is the one to bring him down. Second down, here's Ryan. And he rips that one incomplete there.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
This will be the 8th play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
When you hear screen, screen, screen on defense, that's a little bit scary because you know a big play might result.
He was so ready to get to part 2 of the screen, he forgot part 1, couldn't get the ball. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That'll be out of bounds, and how good was that? They'll say the 3-yard line. That's where they spot him. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Face mask penalty, and Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle, so you end up flailing away, and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
Over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Call it a pickup of 7, and it'll be a second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make it a second down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
On second down, here's Brady. Over the middle, it's complete. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Here's Blunt. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Now that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Brady gives this one to Lewis. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
And they'll run it here. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
So a pause here for us as well. Time to pay some bills. We're back to Super Bowl 51 after this. A reminder, coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. This will be the 8th play of the drive, and it's 3rd and inches. This is Lewis. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. And quickly, they get to the line. They try again with Lewis. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down. Now he'll throw with Brady. That is caught, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Michael Floyd, a 12-yard touchdown grab, and the Patriots have cut it back within a score. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. He's going to go for a big play downfield. It's caught inside the 25. A big play there. Ryan to Jones. 44 yards. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like. Like they're drawing them up in the dirt, and so far it's working for both of them.
Throwing the slant pattern here, complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So they're operating in the red zone. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well. And he didn't get that done on that play.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. And that takes us from second to third down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass, excellent job, way to knock it down.
On third down, Ryan. Getting it out left side to Sanu. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the left hash, a chip shot here. So we've reached intermission in what has been a back-and-forth Super Bowl 51 from Houston. As we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, let's get it going. Here's the first half highlights. Falcons opening the game on offense. Ryan finding Jones over the middle. After the short pass, he'll score. The Falcons is up now by 7. At the end of the first quarter, under duress and the pass is picked off. Collins is the one taking it back for the score. That puts them up by a touchdown. Patriots on offense. First quarter winding down. Under pressure here, the pass is picked off. Allen's in position, and he is the one who comes away with the ball. Now following the interception, Jones is going to haul in the pass, and this play goes for a score. Third and goal. That puts them on top by 14. Here the pass is completed into coverage. It ends up working for a touchdown, trailing now by just a touchdown. Third down from inside the 20. Ryan's on target here, and it leads to a touchdown. That puts them on top by 14. We move late into the second. Catch is made after a quick pass, and he caps off the long drive with the TD, cutting the deficit to 7. Staying late in the second. Here the catch is made way downfield, and that connection will lead to a gain of 44 yards. So that'll do it from here in Orlando. The second half of Super Bowl 51 still to come as we rejoin Brandon and Charles in Houston.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. Danny Amendola on the return. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
They come up in an offset eye. Now a handoff here to his running back. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It'll go as a gain of 12. And it gives the Pats a first down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now a play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Hey, while we have a moment here, wanted to ask you about the Raiders and Texans game. Can you remember a time in the playoffs when you had two teams going up against each other with such precarious quarterback situations?
Normally, it is one team, and the other team, that's where the focus is. You remember a few years ago when T.J. Yates was the quarterback for Houston in the playoffs, and he actually won a playoff game. But in this case, as you noted, both of them. Oakland, it looks like it's going to be Connor Cook, the rookie, taking the first snap for them, although Matt McGloin's still a possibility. And then on the flip side, it was announced by Houston that Brock Osweiler's reclaimed the job because of the injury to Tom Savage. You're exactly right. Precarious quarterbacking as they head into the playoffs. Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. And making their way back out there now, the Patriots defense. And they did well down near the goal line last time, forcing him to settle for a short field goal.
And in today's day and age, settling for a field goal of that distance, it's amazing. You can get 3 points now, where it's going to give you only 1 point for the extra point, which would be a little bit longer. But they have to feel fantastic about only giving up three in that situation. It could have been so much worse.
Yeah, it could have. Now can they carry that over? That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. In trouble, and the ball's out. It's in the end zone loose. And this is recovered in the end zone by the defense. My goodness, what a late turn of events here. Well, we certainly haven't seen many fumble returns for a touchdown in Super Bowl history, but there you go. What a play.
And just think about it. We always talk about the best playmakers make their biggest plays on the biggest stage, and there's none bigger than in the Super Bowl. Remember Von Miller?
Yep.
Strip sack, knocked it free. I think Malik Jackson fell out for a touchdown. We've seen different plays like that throughout the Super Bowls.
And this defense has done this all year long. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. On first and 10, it's Ryan. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Ryan on the the handoff. It's Freeman. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35. The former first-round pick, Shea McClellan, hit on the stop.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First-level defensive line, second-level linebackers, third-level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player.
Time running out here on the play clock. Now it's Ryan. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
From the gun on third down, Ryan. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was hoping to get that one to Tevin Coleman in space, and that'll bring up a fourth down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Here we go on fourth down with Ryan. And it is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Patriots take over. They're going to have terrific field position. And now out come the Patriots. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
In this situation, it's really tough to figure out how to defend because they have plenty of room to still take deep shots at the end zone as they just did there. Yet at the same time, you got to be ready for the short throw. In this case, when you see the cue that they're going for the end zone, retreat and make sure you have a way to play forward back towards the receiver and have a chance to bat the ball away as they did there.
12 yards there as they move the chains.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
They don't give it here to his running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll send the tight end Bennett in motion. And a give this time to the tailback. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up 1st and goal. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
The new acquisition, Martellus Bennett, the intended target, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time, spectacular plays, but when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
They run a draw here on 2nd down. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long 3rd and goal. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Brady now on 3rd and goal. And my goodness, another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll have the football to deepen their own territory as he's brought down at the 5. What a nightmarish game he's having now. 6 interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times.
Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. Another carry for the workhorse tonight, Freeman. And they'll get him down up past the 15. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
And now they're in the hurry up.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And his throw is incomplete.
Well, that pass was inaccurate, so that leads me to bring up our Super Bowl predictions and find out just how accurate they were.
Yours were okay.
Well, it was pretty easy for me. I went out there with some established teams. I went with Green Bay and New England, so I'm still alive in the playoffs. You had Carolina and Pittsburgh?
I did. Now, Pittsburgh obviously has a chance. Carolina does not have a chance.
Listen, you're my partner. Let's just be honest about the whole thing. Did anyone see Carolina having this type of a season?
No, I thought you were going to say, you're my partner, and that's why you do play-by-play and not the analysis. I was going to say, you're exactly right.
No, we split this bad boy 50-50, my man. No, Carolina, that was really a surprise to have the season that they did. I really don't think that Julio Jones could be happier right now. Plenty of catch opportunities in this game. He's converted them, and his team's winning.
And Matt Ryan's happy, too, to have Julio Jones on the other side of these.
Yeah, you know, a lot of times we talk about breaking teams down, and oftentimes it's through a running game. These two, they can break a team down through the air.
And quickly, they get to the line.
On second down, Ryan. Deep drop. He completes it to Jones. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
So completion on second down, that brings up third.
And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Can you believe it? It's a Super Bowl 49 hero, Malcolm Butler.
Let's face it, we're all going to remember Malcolm Butler from the Super Bowl, the interception that reverberates, the one that denied Seattle back-to-back Super Bowl titles. But he's become a very talented, good player in the league. He's not going to just be remembered for one play.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
Here's Brady. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
Play action. Now it's Brady. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Julian Edelman, the intended receiver, and it's fourth down.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Matt Ryan and the offense heading back onto the field. And the passing game, I mean, look at the numbers. It's falling off.
When a team is struggling, sometimes you look at the quarterback. When the quarterback starts to struggle, who goes over and picks him up?
Yeah, that's always a big one, isn't it? Usually, there's a quarterback whisperer somewhere. And what I mean by that is, whether it's an assistant coach, whether it's one of his best friends on the team, someone that can get in his ear, get with him, and say, all right, my man, what do you need? What's going on here? So there's one person he can lean on. He's got to lean on that guy right now.
Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A good pickup there, a 22.
And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over. That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. Working with a second and goal now from the three. Here's Coleman. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Kevin Coleman taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Falcons will extend their lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. Now Jones. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So the Patriots coming out now. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer to this guy? Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And he's got Edelman on the out route. That's complete. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Brady to throw on second down. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
We always hear from coaches how much they like to run crossing routes because they want to hit their receivers on the go, get them the ball, and keep them moving. How about when you hit a tight end that well? Okay, the receivers are going to run past you most of the time. The tight end, they can do their damage a different way, break a few tackles and really scatter some people, can't they?
That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really at the point of attack, the offensive line's just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
Sets up the screen to Lewis. Give him 5 on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down. First down marker at the 31. It's third down, and the offense moving quickly to the line. Throwing is Brady on third down. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Robert Alford. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. The number 7, usually lucky here, not for him. 7 picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened 6 times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he'd won a Heisman Trophy in college, so sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career, but when you talk about 1 game, 7, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw 7 picks. They're going to hurry back to the line now. A 20th carry now for Freeman. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Devin McCourty brings him down. From midfield now, here's Ryan. Backing up, swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It's a four-yard pickup, and that'll make it third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. Ryan now, off the bootleg. And that is incomplete. Levine Toilolo, the tight end, is intended target. And that brings up fourth down.
The days of knowing your assignment, dropping to it, and calling it a day, that's over with. Because now, when you drop into a zone, especially as a defensive back, you're seeing the play in front of you. So if a man wanders into your area, guess what? Now it goes from zone to man coverage in many cases. And on this particular play, able to see the play in front of him, react to it, and knock the ball away. Gotta like what you just saw there, if you like zone defense.
The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Now Brady throwing on second down. He sets to fire deep. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they dropped it. But a great chance to make a big play, that's going to hurt.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
And no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Falcons. They've got the football. They've got the lead as we get set to start the fourth. And not great starting field position here for the offense. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. Now they'll run it on the toss. Muscles him off. And space opened up a bit. He's able to take this out past the 10. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Freeman again. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Dante Hightower on the stop.
Yeah, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
third down, Devontae Freeman. And they're going to get the first down here across the 15-yard line. The gain of four that time as the drive continues. And they're going to speed things up here. On first down, Ryan. His throw incomplete. He was looking for Mohamed Sanu there. And it's second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. They run the play fake to Coleman. Now Ryan. He's going to fire one. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Can you believe it? It's a Super Bowl 49 hero, Malcolm Butler. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. Two-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy, because with a two-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone.
You can feel the anguish all the way up here. It certainly looked like he had that one in the end zone, open, unable to hold on to it.
Brady will try again on second down. Screen pass to Blunt. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Brady now on first down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The former Bill, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Whenever they're trying to attack a zone defense, you're trying to figure out where your gaps are going to be. And depending on what type of zone they're playing, it could be on the outside, it could be in the middle, it could be in the seams and the edges. In this case, they tried to attack the middle of the field, but this zone defense didn't allow it because they were able to see the ball come off the quarterback's hands, and everyone was able to react to the football and knock it away.
It'll be a gain of six, and that's going to bring up a third down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. It reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Call it a gain of 10, and they pick up the first. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get the third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. And he's brought down. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. First and goal. Defense. Now he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. LeGarrette Blount, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Patriots are back within a score. He's having a nice little game. Maybe already has an eye on that third touchdown.
How about what our producer, Christian McLeod, likes to say when they score touchdowns like this? He's put a tent up in Touchdown City.
So that drive goes 8 plays. And it ends in a touchdown run by LeGarrette Blount. Gostkowski now, after the touchdown, he'll send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. He Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those. Maximizing opportunities.
And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. And a tackle there by Chris Long. And quickly, they get to the line. Ryan. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Taking it about the 16. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent. But you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. So the screen good for only two. Now it's third down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Throwing is Brady on third down. And he'll find his man. That's Hogan complete. And the ball is knocked out. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. And he motions the wide receiver. Shift together here from the D-line. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
The good signal callers will never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. On third down, Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
What a catch, and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe about the play, and maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Well, those gloves, they do have a little grip to them,
don't they? They have a little extra tackiness to them now, and I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On second down, Ryan. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. And give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Still in search of the first down after that last completion. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. They're going to hurry back to the line now. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. But we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
On second down, here's Ryan. And this is Gabriel on the catch. The reception good for 7. It's third down. And on 3rd and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. From the gun on 3rd down, Ryan. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Taylor Gabriel, his 2nd touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Falcons will add on to their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his 2nd touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, man. Because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
On 1st down, Brady. To the right side, and he's got Edelman. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 26 yards on the pickup there. And it'll be 1st down, New England. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. And they're going to speed things up here. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. And my goodness.
interception. Picked off by Jalen Collins. And he'll take it all the way out near the 30-yard line. And give him now four interceptions in this game. That's only the third time this has been done since the
I had to calm down, but I was going to get them going. I said, chill.
There have been guys who got four interceptions or more in a game. I mean, most recently since 2000, Delta O'Neal and D'Angelo Hall.
They go play action here on first down. So they took a shot.
Why did McCourty? He had.
I know exactly why he tried to throw the ball to Julio Jones there. He's never considered cover. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him.
Especially on those deep passes. Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. He's going to take another shot here.
There we go. There we go. There we go. There we go. There we go.
McCourty picks it off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. That is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field.
What the fuck? Yo, yo.
Certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot. Great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Mosey off now, man.
See if they can avoid doing it here. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Now Brady, finding time. Over the middle, Julian Edelman, it's complete. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Through the air and a first down. Blunt, the lone running back. And they'll get it up the middle. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And now they're in the hurry up. Brady now to throw. He's got time. Over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. On the crossing route, that's caught, Julian Edelman. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. And quickly, they get to the line. Now Brady.
He had it, man.
Hands there, couldn't hang on. Second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big time drop.
Hey, yeah, he almost had that, boy.
Brady again here on second and 10. And incomplete. Can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect them.
And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
Now play number seven of the drive as they're looking at a third and 10. Throwing is is Brady on third down. He's got a man. It's Mitchell. But he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the five at the four.
I know you've seen that screen play up here in my top 20. I know you see that screen play. Thought I was going to click that screen, didn't you? Why your boy peel off then? Let me see.
So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They've got it second and goal as they look for a late touchdown. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
What you talking about?
Late touchdown. So hold everything.
My eyes are actually. My eyes were ready for that.
This
is what all teams go through. You're at the clock. You're inside 2 minutes.
That was the old Patriots could do. And with the Kobe. And I called it too.
Gaskowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now making their way back out onto the field. They've got the lead by three, late stages of the game. What's the message here? Just hang on to the football? Is it that simple?
That's exactly right, because ball security is paramount. And you got a small cushion, a field goal can tie you, but you don't even think that way. Just take care of the ball, close out the game.
Will they close it out? We're about to find out. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now Ryan gonna give it to Freeman. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and two, it's now third and one.
Are we trying to kill that time? It's not my night. I see you.
It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but
block.
Good block.
Somebody's hit. We're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the
Damn, because I was finna come clapping, man. Boom.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. This is Coleman. And so.
What?
Oh, nifty juke.
So you're going to run out the clock? Man, you better not put that in there, boy. You best not.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Coleman. And now whistles blow, and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So what will they do? On the ground, through the air, let's see. Second and nine.
What do I like to think?
Play up. Got him.
Freeman. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Ryan. He's going to loft one deep left side here.
He couldn't
hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line.
Damn.
Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock, a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock takes 7 seconds, are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they'll handle it. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure the clock stops at every opportunity.
And it's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
How about I sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being real precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. He'll look to throw. Over the middle, Julian Edelman, it's complete. Now everything here, we're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside.
I'm not doing no Hail Mary, nigga. You sound stupid.
And now a first down following that long game.
And so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.
Type in Robert Pollard. Ready. Yeah, bro, you like a little behind the line, bro. Hey, that was a good head game.
Head spit got that winger, though.
You want some? Oh, man, I can't believe I even got down there, bro, with 19 seconds, bro.
Oh,
and this nigga. He said,
ah! I knew what you was going to do. I knew you were trying to get to that line, bro.
With a couple seconds left, but I already got that bitch up. It don't even matter, bro. If I would have got out, nigga, I was right on the line, nigga. I was right on the line, bro. Either way, nigga, I was on the line. What, the field goal? Hell no. That's why I would have made it this time, bro. Ooh, let's see the stats, bro. Boy, look like Tom Brady. Cast him at the end. Hell yeah, 523 yards. Eight, three TDs. He had three interceptions. 55% completion. 55 attempts. Average 8.1. Average pass 57 yards. And no blunt got me. Ooh, Freeman had more though.
Came back.
But nah. I had receiving yards too. So that's 144 plus. Put him over.
I'll have four.
Put him over. Hey, fuck the nigga Collins. Devin solo tackles. Assist.
Damn, hold on. I'm gonna say, how the fuck y'all got 6 interceptions on that side?
15 tackles.
That nigga Beasley got goddamn 2 interceptions for me.
Ball, bro.
Ball.
Hell of a game. Look at that. Met up right at the end, boy. Had me the whole... I wonder what the play of the game is. Damn, whole 15-minute quarter.
Took 2 hours.
It did?
What time is it?
8. What time we started? Like 6?
Ooh. We had to be really overhead kick.
I had to take the number 1. 13-69. 17-67. Devin's still number 1 so far, boy.
Number 10, though.
Mmm. Damn, all these shit close. And the play of the game goes to Dante Hightower.
You got drink. I didn't get beer.
Why you looking at me, bro? I can't believe I lost my field goal.